Here we have a pre-built version of the application. So let's go ahead and run it. And this is the restaurant review training data that we will be using. And we have two reviews that are classified as positive and three that are classified as negative. Now, in a sentiment classification application, we want to auto-classify documents. For example, we want to determine whether a review for a restaurant, a book, or a movie is positive or negative. Now, automatically extracting sentiment is very important for marketing, market prediction, etc. And another important commercial application is email spam detection. And to do this sentiment classification, we will be using a multinomial naive Bayes classifier, where a text document is represented as a bag of words, meaning an unordered set of words with position ignored and only using word frequency within the document, and where it is assumed that the conditional probabilities are independent and thus can be naively multiplied. And here we built a bag of words vocabulary set, which is made up of 15 words, and to overcome multiplying by zero, we use add one Laplace smoothing. And to come up with those numbers, we add 1 to the numerator and add the number of words in the set to the denominator. So we have 9 words in the positive reviews, and we have 11 words in the negative reviews. So 9 plus 15 gives us 24. And 11 plus 15 gives us 26. Next, let's go ahead and auto-classify a new review document. And we are using logs here, since to overcome numerical underflow, which means multiplying many small numbers together, we do language model probabilities in log format. Also, to add in log space is equivalent to multiply in linear space. So we have 2 reviews that are positive and 3 that are negative. So this is where we got 2 over 5 and 3 over 5. And we are taking the log of those to obtain the log prior for positive sentiments and negative sentiments. And we add that to the log likelihood. So for genuine, we have 2 over 24 and 2 over 24 for taste. So we add all those 3 logs together and we obtain this number. And for negative sentiments, we obtain this number. And this number is bigger than this number. So we could have stopped here and concluded that the text is classified as expressing positive sentiment, but I went ahead and went back to the prior plus likelihood gives us this number, and from there I obtained the probabilities of positive and negative sentiments, and those two add up to 1. I will start by creating a new project. And here we will have three classes. An application driver class with a main method. And a class where the naive base logic will be. And a display helper class. And this is the training data that we will be using. So this is just the heading, and here we have two reviews that are expressing positive sentiments, and three reviews that are expressing negative sentiments. And we will pick up the reviews and the labels. And we will have a hash set that will contain all the vocabulary. Now, going to this class, we will have a vocabulary, and we will initialize it in the constructor. And we will use it in this map document to vocabulary method. And we want to keep track of the prior probability. And this method will calculate that. And in the constructor, we will map the data to the vocabulary, and then call the calculate prior probability on the label. And we will be using the commons math to do matrix operations. So I already downloaded it here. So let's pick it up. To properties. And here we want to keep track of the positive probabilities and negative probabilities. And we need this helper log method. And this method will calculate and set the positive and negative conditional probabilities. And we will call it from the constructor. And finally, we will have this public method that does the classification. And now going to the driver class we will have this method that prompts the user to enter a text to be classified. Expressing positive or negative sentiment. Now let's go ahead and test run the application before adding the display code. So this is classified as expressing a negative sentiment. And this is display code. And we will use it here. So first we will instantiate it in this method and call it in calculate conditional probabilities and in the classify method. Finally, let's go ahead and test run the completed application. So maybe try to classify this sentiment. So it is classified as expressing a negative sentiment. And let's try this. So it is classified as expressing a positive sentiment.